Hi guys, today I'm back with some more artist trading coins, and here they are. I think they turned out really cool. I picked up this punch today at my craft store, and it's $14.95 in case you're interested. Yeah, it's more than the die set that I was using before, but I blunted it on the snow effect stuff that I'll show you later. And I have these backings for my artist trading coins. And usually I cut them by hand, and I made them a little bit smaller just so that you can cut them roughly and it will still fit on the coin. But now that I have the punch, I will just use the punch. And I have to say, this little flap door trap thingy, that's already annoying me. I think it might be gone in the next video. I'm just gonna pull it off and yeah. And then I don't really use these sheets. They're called vintage knipvelen, which vintage cutting sheets, and people in the Netherlands use these for their cards instead of stamps usually. And sometimes I get them in a goodie bag. This one particular one is from Marianne Design, and there's a few more in my store, Hobby Voordelig. Also, it's not my store, but the store in my town. Just in case you're wondering, I go there a little bit too often. I can say that it feels like my store, but it's not. And the one I'll end up using in the end is HV, Hobby Voordelig 144, and they're all numbered, so you can keep track of them when they order them online, I guess. And I think they use something like Ravistoks or Dreamstime, to buy the images and then make these sheets. I have no idea actually, but that's what I think she told me once. But as I say, I don't never use them, but because I have these artist training coins, and I kind of like these vintagey ladies, but also these little cute edibles. And this was round to begin with. I thought that would be nice, but I didn't have my little pika hole there. I should have taken that with me, which I would suggest you do if you're looking for images or stamps. And yeah, so you know they fit. And the punch is quicker, I have to admit. It's very friendly to use, but you have to cut off more to get the right placements, whereas dice you can just plonk them on top and then put some for your machine. But you see, I want more house, so I have to cut off a bit more of the bottom, but not too much, because then oh, that's a learning curve, I guess. But it's okay, there was a little tractor or truck there, or horse cart. I couldn't see what it was, but something vintagey, transporty like. See, that my houses are not fitting in the screen. And there's the other house or shed. I wanted that in my other coin, so I'm going outside the edge a little bit. And here you can just see little winter scene with the cabin. It feels so Bob Rossy. Is that a word? Bob Ross like. And to attach them, I also punched out some watercolor panels, which is 300 grams, 140 pounds, to make them sturdy. You can do this with card, of course, as well. And actually, I still die cut these. But yeah, of course, the 2.5 inch, I blunted it on the ice effect stuff that I will show you later in the video. And then I was deciding whether to get a new die set for just the one size or the punch. So I got the punch. You might have seen that. I like to write down with a Sharpie. You can do it with a pen, but don't use a gel pen that's water based, because yeah, it will melt. I'm putting gel medium on top later, once the crackle has dried. And here you can see that it's, sometimes I rough it up, sometimes I just put some distress inks on the bottom, so you just disguise it, or I just make it worse by tearing the paper and make it look more vintagey. Of course, you could have used a smaller die cut as well, and just, but yeah, let's not go there. It's a process. And I'm glad I can still smile at my landlord, or living housing corporation, we say, is renewing the roofs in our area, and the noise is driving me crazy, and I can't do voiceovers except when they're gone at night, because they also work on Saturdays. I noticed that with this gel medium I can't really move it. I have to take it off and replace it. There's no wiggle room, so I have to cut off bits here and there, but that's okay. I don't mind doing that. It's a part of the handmade process, isn't it? I have pulled out the gold rich regular metallic gold with regular blah 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 metallic gold rich regular embossing powder from Wow. But then I thought, you know, maybe silver would be nice as well, but then I ended up using gold because I thought it would be all too silverish. There's already quite a cool colors in the image. So now I'm just doing the edges with oxides, with shaded lilac and Mermaid Lagoon, I think, and Seedless Preserves. And I like to have the edge darker so you get a bit of a frame. And I'm sorry, I'm doing this a little bit off screen. I just bumped the camera, I noticed. But yeah, you get the idea. I like making these little artist trading coins because they're kind of like small mixed media projects. And they're not as daunting as a whole big art journal page or a double spread page, and all empty. Nope. And yeah, that's why I like them, actually. So I thought I should zoom in a little bit. I want to do the edges in gold as well, and just go rubbing around it with the Versamark pad. And here I'm checking if it's dry, and it is. And yeah, I pulled out a page so I could, you know, collect all the powder again. See, it wasn't my finest day. All those workmen left a mess on my balcony and they didn't clean it up. And all the noises, they just make me cranky. They've been drilling all day. It's not nice. But leaving the mess on my balcony, there's all polystyrene trash and cut-ups and plastic foil on that really, really disappointed me. But yeah, anyway, there's I pulled out a few textured like background stamps. These are, I think, from Technique Tuesday or Kaisercraft, I can't remember. They're really old, so I don't think they're available anymore. But any that you have will do, and actually I'm just using the snowflake. And that's from Leanne Creatief, also a few years old, but I'm sure you have snowflake stamps. And like, and I appreciate you can't get these sheets maybe in America. They might send them to America, but just look for postcards. You know, those are a nice and sturdy card as well. Or images in magazines. Packaging, sometimes, you know, you get those fancy Christmas editions and you can just cut them up, you know, and reuse them. You don't have to trash everything. But also don't keep everything, then you become a hoarder like me. No, I paired. I don't keep scraps anymore either. If it's been in a bin of scraps for more than a year, I won't use it. See, I'm showing you, this is what happens when you splatter gold and then knock over the bottle of shimmer spritz and it's all gone in the bin. And it went so quickly, so fluid that it just, yeah, no, it's okay. But I feel like I wasted half the bottle and I didn't do anything pretty with it except make my desk gold, I guess. So I placed three snowflakes on each and I did the edging on all of them just to keep it as a set. And I didn't stamp anything on there. I didn't think there was enough room for Merry Christmas or anything witty. Like baby, it's cold outside. That's three words, three coins. Then it makes it a set. And I'm just embossing it. You know how that works. It's so pretty to look at the embossing powder just change. And I leave a link down below if you're interested. On Facebook, there's a worldwide 80C club, the swapping club. And I already received my first swaps this week, and there's more coming. I'm so excited. You know, you have to send out some that you make if somebody likes them, and then you get some in return. I kind of like the idea of that. You get Happy Mail instead of bills. So, to make it even more vintagey, I thought I should put on some crackle paste. And maybe a text here or there. There's a bit of white left, but I think the image conveys the message. It's winter, it's Christmas, it's snow. I'm so sorry about that. And this is the Viva Decor paste. Ice effect that I blunted my dice on. So die cut first, then put it on. Don't do like me. But yeah, you live and learn. For that, maybe with my gel pen I can write the message in there, but I still don't like my handwriting, so I wasn't going to attempt that. And to put the crackle paste on top, you probably should check first. I don't remember it ever being open like that. My other pots, I think they had some kind of aluminium closure, so I wasn't expecting it to go all over my hands. But then I just pulled out a brush. I think that's easier than a palette knife. And the thicker you put it on, the more crackle you get. But the printed sheet is quite thin, so it does buckle. And I'm okay with that, actually. But just in case you're not, just know that it might do that. So once it's dry, I'm just going to put some gel medium on the back to protect my wording. And I'm trying to show you the crackle. I don't know if you can see it in the light. Yeah, it catches it. It didn't crackle everywhere because I didn't apply it very thickly, I think. But just enough to give you that, you know, antique photo or painting feel. So yeah, where it buckled, I will add some more glue and restick it. But yeah, I like them, and I hope you feel inspired to maybe try your own. And as I say, try and look at your Christmas cards, even that you're getting nowadays or these days or next week, maybe, I don't know. And I will see you again on Wednesday. So thank you for watching, and until Wednesday, bye.